Hi everybody, Kevin at Bear Creek. I'm over here at the farm apiary. Still lots of snow. Supposed to get up to 50 today. Very foggy, supposed to rain like hell. I wanted to get up here and feed these three colonies over here, my remaining three. And then I got all the way here and realized that although I brought my smoker fuel and all the equipment, and I forgot the smoker. So I couldn't put any pollen patty on them, but I did check them, and they still got candy boards with a little bit of pollen on them, which is good. And all three colonies were still alive. These are the three colonies that had died out right after the polar vortex. They were very smaller, very much smaller colonies, and I had noticed mice tracks in there when they were still alive. I just thought they were eating the dead bees down at the bottom, you know, that had fallen out and died. I didn't realize that the mice had actually gone in, and I think that's exactly what happened to these. Well, this is a double nuke. It's exactly what happened to this hive is that I think the mice got to them. Don't know that for a fact, but that's what I think. I mean, this is all chewed up, dead. The bottom frames were all chewed up in wax. There's no nests in there at all. But that's what I think happened. Number one, they weren't quite big enough to defend themselves. Like I said, these were smaller going into winter. The one didn't have a queen, and I had requeened her very, very late when I discovered that it was queenless, and I don't know if they really built up enough. The one thing I did find is that there was actually plenty of honey. Those four frames there on top, all I'm doing right now is I'm cleaning up the boxes. That's such a long walk in here out to the road that I gotta leave these here, but I didn't want to leave dead bees when it got warmer to rot and ferment in the hive, so I just wanted to come out here and clean these up. Somehow I've got to block up those entrances so no more mice go in there and chew any more frames up. But those four frames there are full of honey. You know, even these frames are half full of honey here. So that's what I'm working on right now. I had put the fondant on right before that polar vortex. Well, actually, I put it on in January, and they didn't even touch it. Literally didn't even touch it before they perished. But like I said, I saw the mouse tracks and the chewed up bees down on the ground outside the hives in the winter, and I just assumed they were eating dead bees, but apparently they were going inside and they probably did a number on my bees. So I thought that entrance was small enough for keep mice out, but my bad, it wasn't small enough. So live and learn. But lots of honey left in this hive, so sorry about the bad camera work. Yeah, here's another frame here of honey. Had a little bit of dysentery, they couldn't get out of the hive, obviously. Not horrible by any stretch of the imagination. But I'll turn this back on when I get to this hive over here. Okay, this is the top of that hive. This is actually just syrup on top here from the candy board. Dripped a little bit, but I just pulled out the apivar strip, but just going to take a quick look here and see what's going on with this hive. This was another weak hive here. Look at that, these first three frames aren't even built out. Well, it's built out a little bit. A little bit of nectar in there. This one's not built out. That side's not built out. That one is halfway, partway. Nothing in it. This one's very, very full. Plenty of honey in it. plenty of nectar. Possibly. I know they didn't starve. You know, they didn't cap maybe enough honey. We'll see here. It's all full of nectar there. This is a double, by the way. They did start eating the candy board a bit before they died. That polar vortex is what took them out, but right around that time, it got 35 below for that stretch, a week-long stretch. They got freaking bees on me here. There's honey. Not a lot of bees here though. There's plenty of honey in this hive. Probably just ran out of, they just didn't have enough bees for the size. I'm starting to dial in on the fact that I probably need 3 high on a nuke and 1 deep and a super for my well, those 3 are all singles. Well, that one's a single and a super, it's doing good, and those 2 are singles and those are doing good. Actually, you can kind of see they're coming out right now. That one's got a little bit of a blowout. All these bees are out today. Doing cleansing flights now. They're actually out flying around, which is good to see. Okay. Let's take this box off and see what's below. Okay. This is kind of what I would expect. Bottom box is completely void of any honey. I mean, absolutely empty. Doesn't look like the mice got to this one. They just, and there's about the right amount of dead bees down at the bottom for just a overwintered hive that I would expect. But it does look like this hive was just too small for the cavity. Next year, a deep and a super for my deeps, and triples for all my nukes. That's my goal. I'm starting to just see. Boy, I got bees all over, flying all over. They're attracted to all the honey that's around here, but yeah, I'm looking at the bottom board. You know, not for naught, but I usually would see dotted with varroa like I did last year when I just did this, and I don't see any of that here. So my guess is that polar vortex, the size of the cavity, too few of bees.
So I apologize, my screen crapped out a little bit. There, my camera did right in the middle of that dead out autopsy. But one of the things that I noticed, which was interesting, that's why I wanted to do this real quick. I noticed where the bees were clustered around on the frames, there was actually brood behind that, capped brood, and they didn't want to go off that spot. You know, obviously during that cold snap. That was it for them. That's all it took. And there just wasn't enough bees for that that size, that too deep space to keep warm and to so that they could move off and access a little bit of honey, I guess. That's my take on it. I didn't see any signs of heavy varroa or anything like that when I was checking out the bottom. So, you know, live and learn. Next year, I think I've got this. I'm starting to get this dialed down as I probably enter my third year, fourth year beekeeping for next fall. For my 10 frame hives, I'm going for a deep and a super. Both seem to be my best performing hives. For my nukes, I'm going to go with three high configurations, so three deep boxes for five frame or four frame nukes. I'll have to weigh them empty. I'll have to weigh them, you know, and then weigh them to see how much food that they're going to need. I'll have to try to calculate how much, what my targets are going to be for weight. But that's going to be my goal for this fall. Also, I am not, I repeat, I am not carrying any dink colonies into winter. If I think the colonies are weaker, I will combine them with another colony straight out. I'll get rid of the queen if I have to, but I am not carrying any dinks through because they just can't make it. There is just, maybe down south they can, but up here it's just, it's not even worth it. You know, you spend time making up candy boards and this and that, and then they just, you know, we get that 1 week of just absolutely brutal cold, and that does it to them. I mean, that's it. You know, they can hang on for that long, but that's it. If they don't have the numbers, there's not a chance. And even I think even if you stack hive after hive right next to them, I don't even think that they have much of a chance. So that's my goal for next year. Check out my other video this afternoon. It was kind of nice. It got up to 55 degrees, and my bee, when I got back from the farm, I got back home, my home hives were out in absolute full force, flying frenzy. They were flying everywhere, and it was just a fantastic sight to see. It's been that long of a winter. I can't tell who was happier for the flight, the bees or me, because man, were they out. But so that was good to see that I got everything done that I needed to get done before, because today was predicted rain all day. So I was glad to get everything I needed to get done before the bottom dropped out. And right behind me, the bottom dropped out, and it's now pouring rain. And that's getting rid of our snow fast. I mean, I got a foot of water under my hives right now. Luckily, I got them on 18-inch stands. But that the snow that we had, the 3 foot of snow, is just melting so fast because of the 1 inch of rain we got the night before last, and then now it's pouring rain again. So it's gonna again. I just hope that my bees did not get caught flat-footed out there when the bottom dropped out. I hope not a lot of bees were away from the hive when, because it's just gonna rain. And then it's going to get cold, and they're going to be screwed. So hopefully, most of them made it back to the hive in time. Until next time, happy beekeeping.